Sue McLuhan in June 2005. It's 5 o'clock on a sunny day and Mike has just cut the paths. They look much better for their haircut. Between the trees we can see the buttercups and daisies and other flowers all jostling together, swaying in the breeze. And robin sings. We had a lot of birds' nests here last year, 7 I think, but we don't discover them until the autumn and the leaves fall off the trees. This is our northern edge. The evening shadows are beginning to fall, so I'll head towards our summer house. A new one for the past couple of years. The old one did very well, but began to fall to pieces, so we've got a new one. Buttercups and daisies have just lately opened out. Cow parsley still blooms in the hedgerows. Our old dining table and chairs is a pleasant setting for a shady picnic. And the view from the shed is stunning. If I says so, I shouldn't. This year has been the year of the wild orchid, because we discovered in the spring we had 40 wild orchid plants, which is far more than we ever have before, popping through. This common spotted orchid. We hope they'll all bloom, but just to have them there is lovely. Yellow rattle is another flower that we're encouraging, because it feeds on grass through its roots and lets the wild flowers through instead. More wild orchids. And our trees, which we planted in front of the existing ones, all chaffinch singing to us, great tick calling, have flourished, as you can see. Some of them are nearly as tall as the ones they're standing in front of. Don't know if you can hear the flutists squeaking in their nest box. I won't dilly-dally, because the parents get very upset if we put an appearance when they come in with the latest batch of caterpillars. Early purple orchids had a good year too. We had 10 of those, some there and some there. They're going to seed now, but with a bit of luck, their seeds will multiply for next year. Nice corner table and bench to relax on. Particularly nice at sunset. The grass is lit from behind the slanting rays of the setting sun. There's a little owl who gets full value of it every day. The beech hedge between us and the village school is flourishing too, which is excellent. Stops the children getting a cold in winter when the wind blows. Here is a nice shot of the eastern edge again, with all the flowers in front of it. Close up here, while jackdaws call, of buttercups and daisies. They're not rare, but they are beautiful. So now, while a plane drones overhead, and a robin sings from our trees.